Hello friends, this is the story of attempting to record 3dektek 289. We have been working, and I say we because there's all kinds of new characters in this episode helping us out, of trying to get 3dektek recorded in various locations and the problems that we ran into. We've been doing this for 3 days now. We're on day four of just problem after problem after problem. It's become comical enough that to the point where the story has to be told. Day one started by scouting out a location we had heard about 2 miles up a mountain on top of a hill with a fantastic view. It sounded like a perfect location. But unfortunately, we were unable to get permission to use the facility in time of the recording, so we had to go with plan B.
Well, this is day two of the 3dektek setup, and now we've got the generator, we've got the DJ equipment, we've got the big table. We just gotta grab Jonathan, and then we're off to set up at the blowholes. To start with the madness.
What up? So welcome to 3dektek 289? Yeah, 289. We are trekking about a mile and a half into the woods to record at a awesome blowhole. This is gonna be completely amazing if we pull this off. However, in order to pull it off, we have to carry all this stuff. This generator weighs 60, 70 pounds. We're gonna try to find a stick to make like a sling to carry it. All the equipment, a table. Whew! And it is, about 95 degrees out right now with no wind. Sweating my balls off, as it were. But luckily I got some tropical Sherpas here to help me.
Tropical Sherpas.
We are at the 3dektek location about an hour and a half later. Woo, it was brutal, but Dominican Republic style. Got me some amigos here. Salute. This is base camp. We've got a little bit of a campfire going. Chris is gonna cook up some what?
Land crab.
Land crab. All right, let's get the show on the road. We'll be right back. recording went off without a hitch. The intro was really cool, had a bunch of waves coming up during the shout out. And I have opted to go with two different camera angles, one directly on looking at it and one off to the side. And the one off to the side, I didn't really feel like captured the what I was looking for in the energy of the wave coming up and the music, and it was kind of a little too far off, and I really wasn't pleased with it, so I couldn't really use that. And the head-on direct recording, we thought was everything was fine. I looked at the footage in the evening just to see what the next day was going to bring, and when I woke up in the morning and put the SD card into my computer, it somehow became corrupt, and I lost the entire recording. I spent a better part of 4 hours working on different recovery software options, and it was dead. The SD card had failed. There was no chance of getting the footage back, so all was lost for that attempt at that point. We decided to try to make one more crack at it, but this time see if we could arrange a little transportation, as none of us were up to carrying all the equipment out there again, myself included. It was brutal. And so we found somebody that actually was like, hey, I've got a drone that we can go out and film as well, so possibly better. He had a truck, so we loaded up all the equipment, took the drive out to the location, which was a whole different route in, but when we got to the gate, it was locked and the keys were not available to open back up to us. So we no longer were able to record at the blowhole and had to think of another plan. I had heard of another hike that you could take to a top of a plateau on the north coast of the Dominican Republic coastline here as well, that overlooks Luperon Bay, that would have a very nice view of a sunset. But we were running out of time and only had one shot at it. So we drove all the way back across the other side of the town, an island here, to a location to get a nice sunset. All was going well. We had got the equipment set up. We started with enough time to capture the sunset. GoPro screen had froze. It still actively showed it recording once Alex found out that it was frozen, so we had to just kind of keep going and hope that it was going to come out fine. I get back to the boat to review the footage, and indeed, after about 11 minutes, the rest of the duration of the hour was completely frozen at one frame. I did get the audio recordings for the sets, and I am offering those up for free on my Patreon page. Normally this is a perk to the patron only folks, which you guys can obviously become if you would like to get MP3 downloads of all the 3dektek. This one is over at my Patreon page. I invite you guys to go download the audio to hear what the set was going to be like, even though we were unable to capture it on video. But I shall return to the blowhole location for the next 3dektek. It will happen. It is going to happen. Gonna figure out what's going on with these cameras and solve that. But times are getting pretty tough to be accomplishing all these recordings. My laptop is starting to die. My cameras are starting to die. It is not a good situation. Never more have I needed your guys' help. I'm sorry to be asking, but if you're loving the adventures and you're liking the 3dektek at all these cool spots, I need your help on my Patreon page. Kick a couple bucks here or there to a lonely pirate. Give me a hand and we can keep moving this project forward. I hope you guys enjoyed the story. Sorry we weren't able to get a 3dektek up this month, but we'll get one at the blowhole soon, I promise. Cheers, guys.